can see the waters raging at my feet. I can feel the breath of those surrounding me. I can hear the sound of nations rising up. We will not be overtaken, we will not be overcome. I can walk down this dark and painful road. I can face every fear of the unknown. I can hear.
Father, thank you for your love. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for the fact that we can be in your presence this morning, knowing that you love us so much and that you truly are the God who wants to be a part of our lives every moment of every day. Dankie Here dat u planne, unieke planne vir elkeen van ons het. Help ons om gehoorsaam aan u plan, u wil te wees in elke oomblik van elke dag. Hierdie diens is deel van u plan vir die wat hier is vanoggend. Praat met ons Here. Dit gaan nie oor mensgemaakte reëls en agendas en planne. Dit gaan oor 'n ontmoeting met God die Vader. Help ons om dit te besef en dit te beleef in hierdie diens. Help us to understand that this church service is not about entertaining one another. It's not about putting on a show and putting in our smiling teeth. It's about meeting with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. It's about having you, God, have your way in our lives. Speak your truth. Praat u waarheid met elkeen van ons. Help ons om ons lewens in lyn met u waarheid te kry. En nie die waarheid te buig om by ons te pas. And so, Father, we submit to your lordship. We submit to your kingship, to your rulership in our life. And we ask you to speak to us in this service. To mold us, to shape us, to challenge us, to equip us. Father, we've heard so much good advice from earthly fathers who've lived it out practically before us. Father, thank you that your advice comes from your Son, who came to earth and lived practically in front of us. And so help us to see Jesus in the words this morning, to see how he lived his life, an example to each and every one of us. Father, I pray for those who need prayer this morning, those who need a healing touch physically. Won't you touch them, Lord, and heal them in Jesus' name. Those emotionally and financially and spiritually who need to be lifted, who need to be equipped, who need to be filled, Father, come and meet those needs in Jesus' name. But Father, now we submit in quietness to your will and ask you to speak to us in fullness, in power, and in glory. Thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Turn to Matthew chapter 6, Matteus hoofstuk 6. En soos ek gesê het, die tema of die titel van my boodskap vanoggend is goeie advies, goeie raad. Good advice. And where better to get good advice about a good father who is in heaven, but from his son Jesus Christ. Just as I asked each of you to give advice that you heard from your father, only you could give it because you knew and you know your father. Yes? Because you know your father, you can best describe, you can best put into words what the advice is that he gave you that was meaningful and that was impactful on your life. So where better to hear good advice about God but from his son Jesus? So I want you to turn to a very, very well-known portion of Scripture. In fact, you don't even have to read it. I can ask you to recite it, and you'll be able to recite it. Matthew 6 from verse 9. Jesus says, pray then in this way. Pray then in this way. And what's interesting is he's saying, pray then in this way. He doesn't say, pray this way. Because if he said, pray this way, then he would want you to memorize it and recite it and to say it as a prayer. But he says to you, pray in this way. In other words, use this as a formula. Use this as a pattern. Use this as a means of establishing. Now, the interesting thing is in Luke, we know that he says this in response to one of the disciples that came to him and said to him, Rabbi, teacher, teach us to pray. Why did the disciple ask that? Because Jesus prayed in a certain way. When he prayed, there was a connection. When he prayed, there was impact. When he prayed, there was meaning. When he prayed, there was just something awesome about his prayers. And the disciples came to him and said to him, teach us to pray, because when you pray, things happen. When last did one of your children come to you and say, teach me to pray, Daddy? Well, let me ask this. Do we still pray? Is prayer our first go-to? Well, let's leave it at that. Let me let all the fathers off the hook, because it got very quiet there. I even heard you stop breathing. Let me just say to you, fathers, you're off the hook. You're not perfect. Okay? God is the only perfect father. So you're off the hook. None of you have to match up to God's fatherhood. Is that okay? But don't behave in such a way that when your children meet the good father, they are so marred and so scarred that they can't relate to the term father. So be present, be innovative, be involved, be there. Okay. But you're off the hook. You don't have to be perfect. I thought I'd get an amen or a thank you there. Okay. All right. Well, what's the good advice that I want us to take in this morning? Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. That's the advice that Jesus gives us. It's not a prayer. It's a pattern of prayer. 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 17 says, pray without ceasing. Bid sonder einde. Ophou. Wat beteken dit? Wel, jy moet 'n gesindheid, jy moet 'n lewenstyl, jy moet 'n benadering tot die lewe hê wat 'n gebed is. Wat's 'n gebed? Kom ek verduidelik vir julle. Kom ek gee julle goeie raad vanoggend. 3 punte uit die Onse Vader wat jou gaan help om die lewe aan te pak en terselfdertyd bidend te wees. So forget about our Father, Onse Vader wat in die hemel is, as a prayer. Think of it as an attitude, as good advice from Jesus, who's saying, you know what, when I look at my Father, when I live with my Father, when I see what my Father does, when I experience my Father, this is the advice I would give you from His heart to you this morning. Pray in this way. Our. Let's start with our. You must have, what's my first point? Oh yes. You must have the right place. You must have everything in the right place. Sit alles in die regte volgorde. Kry alles reg. You know when you want to put something together, you know what's always a good thing to do? Is lay it out beforehand. Okay, you don't want to start doing something like fixing a baling machine, Uncle Mark, and then have to run off to town 70-100 times to get this and get that and fix this and fetch that, and then celebrate when the baling machine is fixed. Set it all out. Make sure you've got everything. Know that, okay, this, then this, then this, then, and dan gebeur dit baie makliker. Is it nie so nie? Okay, it's a pleasure. It's a bit late. I know. We speak out of experience. Okay, you know what's so awesome? You want a good marriage? You want to raise good children? Get things in the right order. Hello? Don't have children and wait for them to give you the go-ahead to get married. It Just get it. Get it right from the beginning. If that makes sense. Is dit sin maak? As jy iets wil aanpak, maak seker jy het alles. Voordat jy begin, want daar's niks wat so frustrerend is as jy het net begin en besef jy, ek het die nodig, ek het daai nodig. Die tools wat jy nodig het, kry, raak, dan word dit makliker. So get everything in place. What's the first thing he says? He says, hour. Hour. You know what's so awesome about hour? It means us. It means this isn't your father, this is our father. Now, listen to me. I've had people come to me and say to me, I want to be a Christian, but do I have to go to church? I'll say, not really. I mean, it's Jesus and that's all. You need Jesus in your heart. If you accept him as Lord and Savior, you're a Christian. But then I say to them, but try be a soldier without an army. Try be a rugby player or a netball player or a hockey player without a team. That's going to be fun. Let's play rugby. Woo! Do it again, Dad. Wow, I'm a rugby player. You need a team, don't you? So our father means you and me. It's our. Dis 'n ons ding. It's a our thing. Dis nie 'n ek ding nie. Dis nie 'n jy ding nie. Dis 'n ons ding. Maak dit sin. Our. Get that into your head. It's an our thing. Yeah, but you know what? What did Gandhi say? I would be a Christian if it weren't for the Christians. Okay? How many of us? There's that song. I've sung it how many times to you guys. You never want to learn it. Oh, to live with the saints above. To live with the saints above. Oh, what glory. To live with the saints below. That's another story. But you know what? You can't carry on until you start with our. So, should church be a choice or a lifestyle? Should church be an option? Should fellowship with the saints be something that we skip? Or should it be something that we look forward to? You know what helps? Stop saying to yourself, I must go to church today. Say, I get to go to church today. That works, okay? It's not, oh, I must make coffee again. I get to make coffee again. See the difference? We're the children, they're not here. Okay, so the first thing that we need to sort out is it's an hour thing. And the hour thing is given to the disciples. Dis aan die disippels gegee. Jesus is besig met die bergprediking in Matteus 6, maar as jy na Lukas kyk, dan het die disippels na hom toe gekom en gesê, leer ons hoe om te bid. Hierdie is 'n disippel ding, dis nie 'n algemene ding nie. Jy moet in verhouding met God wees deur Jesus Christus om hy ons te wees. It's not just a general thing. That's why many people pray that our Father, die onse Vader word hoeveel keer gebid. But you have to be in discipleship. You have to be its hour. It's owned, it's ours. They saw his connection with God and they said, teach us to get in connection with God. In fact, the next word is Father. Thank you. Our Father. Remember, we're getting things in the right place. So it's our, second word, Father. And what's so awesome about Father is it serves to remind us that only those in relationship, those who are disciples, are given this prayer to pray. It's our Father. You can't be 'n weeskind en sê ons se Vader. You can't be outside of the family and say our Father. One of the generals was riding in Rome and he was coming back and he had a successful campaign. So he was riding through the streets and he had all the prisoners and all the gold and all the treasures and everything. And he was riding through and the legionnaires were lining the streets to keep the people away. And as he was riding down the road, this little boy ran to get through to get in front of the crowds. And one of the Roman legionnaires said, "Hey, you can't go there. That's my general. And you can't go to him." And he said, "He may be your general, but he's my daddy." And it was the guy's son. And he let him go. And guess what? He jumped on the chariot. Okay? He has to be your father. He has to be your daddy. Hy moet jou pa wees. Ons is besig om die regte goed in die regte plek te kry. Want hierdie is goeie advies. Is nie 'n gebed nie. As jy die dag begin, luister mooi, as jy die dag begin met ons, nie ek. If you start the day with our, this is our day. There's other people immediately in your thinking. Our Father, if you start with our Father, there's relationship, there's connection, there's a special, doesn't matter who tries to keep me away, I'm going to get to God today. Does that make sense? Our Father. Up to that point. Up to the point that Jesus came to earth. Tot Jesus aarde toe gekom het, het die Jode, hulle het nie eens gewaag om God se naam te skryf. Hulle het net they just put the vowel, the not the vowels. They left the vowels out. They put the consonants. Dis die woord. Yes. Kan nie eens in Engels dink nie. Consonants. Okay, so they didn't even write his name out. And they never spoke his name. And then Jesus comes and says, Yahweh, Jehovah, no man, Daddy. No one else could introduce God to us as Father, except his son Jesus. And Jesus comes and says, He's our Father. You want to connect? See your connection. You want to get God involved in your thinking, in your life? Realize you have a Father. And then it says, in heaven, getting things in the right order. Our, it's an our thing. Today, it's about us, not me. I have a relational father who's intimately involved in my life. He's a good father. We'll get there just now. Okay? And he's in heaven. Onse Vader wat in die hemel is. What in heaven? Well, heaven shows us his holiness and his power. So as you go into today, it's our Father who's holy and powerful. So it's not my pal, it's not my chaba, it's not the big guy in the sky, it's our Father who's in heaven, who's holy. And we're going to get to hallowed be your name. It's not Harold, it's hallowed. Hallowed be your name. Okay? Wait, it gets better. Okay. Our Father in heaven, who's holy, who needs to be approached with awe, with reverence, so it brings the balance. And he's powerful. He has the resources of heaven. Now let me just say to you, what do you need? Wat het jy nodig? Enigiets in die wêreld? Nou kom ek laat julle in op 'n geheim. Toe die wêreld woes en leeg was en daar niks was nie, het God dit wat nie bestaan laat ontstaan. Out of nothing, he created everything. What do you need? That's the resource of heaven. Is there anything impossible for God? Because out of nothing, he created everything. What do you need? He's in heaven. He's not on earth. He's not limited. It's not a zero-sum game. Every time he gives something, he's got less to give away here. Okay? Julle boere. Ek sien dit reën op jou plaas. Dis my reën daai. Nee, werk nie so nie. The Lord's got enough. He's in heaven. His resources are limitless. What do you need? You see how this is getting things in order. I want to go face today. I want to go do this year. I want to go do life. I want to go be who God's made me to be. Why? Because we need me to be who God wants me to be so that I can help you become who God wants you to become. And our joint effort is to be the body of Christ who represents our Father who's in heaven. A personal, intimate, relational. Not only does he give us life, but he chooses us. He adopts us. After he gives us life, he adopts us. I can't stress enough. I wish I could share my heart with you. I've never been adopted, but I've dealt with adopted people. And you can't believe the hunger and the desire in the adopted person to just know that they accepted and that it's going to last forever. You can love them. You can be unconditional. You can be everything. But there's a desire in them just to satisfy and to be satisfied and to be. And God says, not only do I give you life, but I choose you. I adopt you. I take you in, and I know that you have needs, and I know that you have wants, and I know that you have all these doubts and these questions within yourself as to whether you're good enough. But you are, because I've adopted you. I gave you life and I've adopted you. Ek het jou lewe gegee en ek het jou aangeneem. Ek het jou gekies. This morning, Shannon came and gave me a hug and said, thanks for being my daddy. I know you didn't have a choice. Yeah, I'm stuck with her. And Wesley. You know, you give birth to them, but then what? Last week I said, my favorite kids are the neighbors. Okay? You're stuck with them. But you know how awesome it is to say, not only did I give birth to you, but I choose you to be my child. Now that I see what you're becoming, oh, brother, sister, mother, I still love you and I choose you. Isn't that awesome? That's our Father in heaven. Hallowed be his name. Now, in order to hallow, what does hallow mean? It means holy. It means set apart. It means revere. It means place it in a special place of specialness. Okay? Maak het sin? Is julle met my? Dis baie stil vanoggend. Okay, in order to hallow somebody's name, the person's name doesn't just tell you who they are, but it tells you their character. Okay? So if I say to you, hey, do you know Sean? Yeah, ons ken vir Sean. Ons het al... Nee, wacht, bly bietjie weg, moenie te naby aan daai ou kom. Do you know Piet? Do you know Koos? Yeah, if I mention a name, each one of you may think of a different person, and it immediately, you think of not just the person's name, but you think of their character. You either recommend them or you warn against them. Ja, jy moet hom leer ken. Dis 'n goeie ou daai. Wag. Wees versigtig met daai ou. Moenie alles glo wat hy... See how quickly you make the association with a name to the person's character. Yes? What do you know about God's character? In order to hallow his name, you need to know that he exists. That he is. You need to know that he exists. Does that make sense? You need to know that God exists. You need to know what his character is. What is his character? He's holy. He's just. And he's loving. What does that mean? God is holy. There's none like him. He's just. In other words, alles sal regverdig. Alles sal uitwerk aan die einde. Al lyk het nie so nie. Aan die einde gaan alles uitwerk. Soos wat het moet. Die wat moet... vir hulle slegte dade beoordeel word. Dit gaan gebeur. die wat loon moet kry vir hulle goeie dade, dit sal skiet. You can trust in God's justice. Not in your time, in His time. And He's loving. What does it mean that He's loving? I wrote this because He's not only holy and just and loving, but He's also powerful. Listen to this. We tell ourselves that the power of God is always motivated by the love of God and can never be exercised for anything but our good. We tell ourselves that the love of God is backed by the power of God and that therefore its purposes can never be ultimately frustrated or defeated. So you need to know that God exists. You need to know His character. You need to know that He's present. He's with you every moment of every day. And then you need to know that He is to be obeyed. Obeyed. Jy moet hom gehoorsaam. Dis hoe jy iemand se naam heilig maak. That's how you honor somebody's name. You need to know that they exist. You need to know what their character is. You need to know that they're present, that they see. And then you need to obey. Think about your personal relationship. Okay? How many of you know that I'm married to Nolene? Okay? Only Nolene doesn't know. No. Okay. How many of you know that I'm married to Nolene? I don't have to prove it because you know it. And you see her with me when I can't get rid of it. No. You see her with me. We do things together. Okay? You know her character. And you know that I obey her in everything. That's how I honor her. Huh? Come on. Make it practical. I accommodate. Yeah? It's gone quiet again. I don't know why. Okay. When God is in the right place, all the other things fall into place. When you have the right order, it's easier to put the rest of your life into order. When you have things in the right order, your life is easier to get ordered. That's why. Our Father in heaven, here comes, hallowed be your name. In other words, get His character, get His existence, get His presence, and get His obedience, get obedient to Him. And then we can say, your kingdom come. Your will be done. As I go into today, our, not my, Father, personal, connected, in heaven, powerful and holy, I hallow your name by acknowledging your existence, by knowing that you're present, by knowing your character and obeying you. As I go into today, guess what happens? It's not my will and my kingdom, it's your will and your kingdom that gets done. But if those things aren't in place, those other things aren't going to be in place. I know many Christians who say, your kingdom come, your will be done. But then I look at their life and I think, ek weet wie is baas van daardie plaas. Jy sê dis sy wil, maar ek sien jou wil wat so deurkom. Al sê jy wat? Onthou, jy luister nie na die woorde, jy kyk na die vrug wat hang. Let me just say this. Be careful. Be careful. Christians, be careful. You dare not judge another person's motives. God will reveal their motives to you one day. But you may judge their actions. We have the right to speak into bad fruit that's hanging. But don't get caught up in their motives. You don't know their motives. Only God does. Okay. Because if we get caught up in judging other people's motives, God's kingdom and God's will never be done through our life. Because we won't be able to accept other people. Okay, so right things in place. Now we've got to get the right perspective. Right perspective. Give us this day our daily bread, Father, Give us this day our daily bread. When do I need my daily bread? In today. In other words, in the present. So as I go into today, God the Father gives me all that I need because He's in heaven and He has limitless resources. Hy het oneindige voorsiening, so hy kan my daaglikse brood. Wat is my daaglikse brood? Dit wat ek nodig het. Nie dit wat ek altyd noodwendig wil hê nie, maar dit wat ek nodig het, sal God vir my voorsien in daai dag. Maak dit sin? So in die teenwoordigheid, in the present, Father, give me today what I need to get through today, because you're our Father in heaven, your name is hallowed, and excuse me, and your kingdom and your will is going to be done through my life, so you know what I need in order to get through this day. I've got a plan and I kind of know what I have to do, but Lord, your will, your kingdom, so you're going to give me what I need that I don't even know I need. Because remember, in another place in the Bible, it says to us, you cannot even ask or imagine. He will supply what you cannot even ask or imagine for. So leave it up to God, because you know what? You're not going to imagine what you need. 32 years ago, I said to Nolene, I do. I didn't know what I needed at that stage. 32 years later, I still don't know what I need. We're still finding each other. I can't wait for this year, because you know what? It's going to be a glorious year of discovering new things that Nolene's going to be. I never imagined I would need Nolene. But God gives you what He sees you need. Give us this day our daily bread. What's the next one? Forgive us our... Okay. When do trespasses happen? In the past. Okay. Who deals with sin? Who deals with hurt? Who deals with past? Who deals with forgiveness? Jesus. Okay. So God the Father gives us today our daily bread. Jesus deals with our past hurts and our past sins and our past everything that needs to be forgiven. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive. Now, don't get me wrong here. God's forgiveness of you is unconditional, except by faith. You need to. You're saved by faith. So you don't forgive in order to get forgiven. So what does it say here? Forgive as I've forgiven. You cannot forgive unless you know you're forgiven. You can't give what you don't have. Maak dit sin. Jy kan nie gee wat jy nie het nie. Soos wat ek God se vergifnis en sy genade beleef, kan ek dit dan vir ander mense gee. So I can't forgive if I don't realize I'm forgiven. So God the Father, meet my needs today. In order for me to live in today, I need to put off yesterday's hurts, yesterday's accounts, yesterday's fakture wat ek uitgedeel het. Jy skuld my, onthou jy dit, ek het dit vir jou gedoen, onthou jy het my te na gekom, onthou jy dit van my gesê, onthou jy skuld my nog vir daai wat ek vir jou ge... Al daai fakture. Forgive. Jesus deals with the past so that we can fully live in the present. You see how this is good advice? It's not a prayer. Okay, it is a prayer, but it's a prayer for good advice. And then, lead me not into temptation, but deliver me from the evil one. Where do I get led to? Into the future. O, jong, ons is stadig. Ons moet hierdie vak oordoen. Ons moet daar. Hulle is nie reg vir hierdie toets nie, Leon. Okay. Die toekoms. Okay, so what is it? What is the our Father telling us? God, if you get Him in the right place in your thinking, your perspective about today will change, because yesterday will have been dealt with. You'll be able to go into today with a clean heart. You'll be able to answer every phone call without first checking who's phoning, because there's a history. Okay? And you can face every tomorrow with a hope that the Holy Spirit, who leads us into all truth, who shows us the Father heart, who directs and leads and guides us, the Holy Spirit. So, guess what? In the Our Father, Jesus is saying to us, hey, get the full picture of the full working of God in your life. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. You need all three working in your life every moment of every day. God the Father who gives you your needs today. God the Son who deals with all your hurts and your pains and your teleurstellings and dit wat jou bitter en seer en die onvergifnis en al daai goed. Jesus is hier en ons gaan na hom toe. Die Heilige Gees lei ons tot in staat te wees om alles aan te pak. I've been called to places. Then they phone me and they say, listen, we got this problem. I've never in my life encountered or met or dealt with such a problem. And they say, can you help? I say, yeah. They say, are you sure? Yeah. And on the way there, boy, do I pray. Because I know I can't, but I know he can. Hey? Yeah, come on. Come on. Make a decision. Hey? Own it. Pitch up. You and God are a majority. Eh? Come on. Then they sit there and they describe the problem. I say, you know what? I don't have an answer, but guess what? I'm going to pray for you. Phew. Okay. The comforter, the counselor comes alongside us and he leads us into every tomorrow. So, realizing that the fullness of God is with me. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit helps me deal with my past. It gives me the hope to go into today, knowing that everything that I need will be given to me. And as I go, the Holy Spirit will lead me and give me the wisdom and the guidance that I need in order to be a success. So, my third point, the right promise becomes ours. What's the right promise? What do you mean by promise? Well, what does the prayer say? For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory. Sometimes I say forever. Amen. So, how do I deal with life? How do I deal with life? If I'm a disciple, as ek 'n disipel is, hoe hanteer ek lewe? Met die goeie raad wat Jesus vir my gee oor God die Vader. Hy is ons Vader in die hemele. Geheilig sy naam. Laat sy naam heilig wees in jou harte. Hoe doen 'n mens dit? Jy weet dat hy is. Jy weet dat hy teenwoordig is. Jy weet wat sy karakter is. Hy is heilig. Hy is regverdig. En hy is liefdevol. En jy gehoorsaam hom. As jy dit doen in die dag, dan sy koninkryk en sy wil sal in jou hart geskied word. Jy sal genoeg hê vir elke dag. Jou gister sal jy kan ontleed en sin van maak en deurwerk en wegpak sodat jy nie in gister leef nie. En jy sal elke môre met 'n hoop en met 'n opgewondenheid opstaan en sê, "Yes, I've got it tomorrow." Why? Because his is the kingdom. His is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Pray without ceasing. Don't say the Our Father. Live the Our Father. Listen to Jesus' good advice this morning about our good, good Father who's in heaven. Because he loves you, you are who you are. Hear that this morning. Listen to me. Listen to me. Last week, the troubles, the financial pressure, sickness, the spiritual attack, everything that happened that's brought you to this point is what God is using to form you, to shape you, so that you can realize you are who you are, not because of what you've done and what you've been through, but because he loves you. You are you who you are because he loves you. Why am I stressing this point? Because listen to me. If you know, as jy weet dat jy geliefd is, dat jy okay is, jy het 'n geskiedenis, dankie tog vir die geskiedenis. Waar is jou kleinkind, Chris? O, daar, nee, nie buite. Ouma het hom gekaap. Wat sy naam weer? Evandrey. Sy eerste keer in die kerk vanoggend, ons kerk. Hy was al in die kerk, maar eerste keer in ons gemeente. Ok. Hy het nie 'n baie lang geskiedenis nie, nê? Nee. Hy het nog nie so baie aangejaag nie. Hy het nog nie iemand te vuishou gegee nie. Hy het nog nie iemand gevloek of lelik van iemand ek kan nog nie praat nie, nê. Beskermd is hy. Ok, hy het nie 'n lang geskiedenis nie. Maar hy het wel 'n geskiedenis. Watter dag was hy gebore? 6 April. Sien, daar klaar. Hy het 'n geskiedenis, hy is 6 April gebore. En soos elke dag wat hy deurgaan, is hy geskiedenis besig om. So listen, don't disown your past. Accept your past. Let Jesus sort it out. So that you can be who God wants you to be going into tomorrow. Because it's about our Father. Let me go back to our. Today's Father's Day. Ephesians 6 tells us, reminds us of the Ten Commandments. It says, honor your mother and your father, and it will go well with you, and you will live long in the land. The only commandment in the Ten Commandments that comes with a blessing and a promise. Okay, it'll a double promise. It'll go well with you, and you'll live long. If you just honor your mother and father. Okay, then it says in verse 4, fathers, moenie aanjaag nie. Okay. What it basically says is, don't frustrate your children. Don't cause them to be rebellious. That's why I said to you, you can't be perfect, but just make sure that you're present and you're consequential and you're involved. Okay. What's interesting? The first three commandments say, I'm God, there's no other. Don't make any idols and don't use my name in vain. The fourth commandment is, honor your mother and your father. Get the right things in place. Our Father says, our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Get God first. And then honor, okay, honor becomes important. Because if you know that God honors, loves, forgives you, you will be able to honor, love, and forgive other people. So by the way, why is that the first of the rest of the commandments? Because not everyone will get married, so they may not have to not commit adultery. Not everyone will want to steal, but everyone has a mother and a father. You may not have any more, but you always had a mother and a father. Okay? And it's a three-generational command. It's to children, parents, and grandparents. There's got to be honor. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. How do we make that happen? We honor one another. We honor one another. How do we honor people? How do we honor God's name? We acknowledge their existence. Come on. We acknowledge their existence. We get to know their character. We get to see their presence in our life. We acknowledge not just their existence, but their presence in our life. And then we seek to honor, we seek to obey. Are there blacks and whites in South Africa? Yes. We're called to honor. Acknowledge the presence. Acknowledge that they're present in your life. You can't wish them away. Get to know their character. Before you label, before you discriminate, before you prejudge, get to know their character. And then seek to honor and obey. That's our His kingdom. Because it's our Father. It's not my Father. It's not just about me, myself, and I. It's about giving everybody in our country, in our town, in our neighborhood, in our homes. Hello? Who's the youngest son? You don't exist yet. Just get out the way. When you see me walking down the path, just move. I'll walk over you. Okay? Until you're that high, you don't count. No, no. We must honor in our own homes. It's nie net eer jou moeder en vader. Eer en respecteer die kinders wat in jou huis is. That's a hard way to end. But you know what? It's needed because it's good advice. We need to honor one another. We need to honor and respect one another. And it comes from our Father in heaven. Father, thank you that you are in heaven. Dankie Here dat U ons Pa is, ons hemelse Pa. U is 'n goeie, goeie, liefdevolle Pa. Dankie dat U laat toe dat mense leef, maar daar gaan 'n dag kom waar rekenskap, verantwoording gaan gedoen word. Want U is 'n regverdige God. U is 'n liefdevolle God. Help ons om dit te besef. Help ons om hierdie goeie raad van U seun te aanvaar. Nie as 'n gebed nie. Pray in this way. In other words, live this way. Don't just pray this prayer. Live this prayer. Jesus, come and deal with my yesterday. Holy Spirit, come and lead me into tomorrow. God, come and provide for everything I need today. As I take that and I live it, I will bring you honor and glory. Lord, I pray for those who are hurting, who need to have their pasts dealt with. I pray for those who are fearful of tomorrow. Come, Holy Spirit, and assure them of your presence. Father, those who don't even know how they're going to get through today, let them go on their knees and say, Our Father in heaven, Our Father in heaven, Our Father in heaven. Get things in the right order and your life will be ordered. Get things in the right place and you'll be able to put things right and in place in your life. And Father, give the church the witness that it needs, and that is to honor all people. How can we praise God with our mouths and curse other people at the same time? Out of the same heart, the same stream. How can bitterness and sweetness come? If we can praise you, we can praise those who you made and gave life to. Help us, Father, to honor you. May your kingdom come. May your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. In Jesus' name. Amen.
All God's children singing out, we will not be overtaken, we will not be